गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू माई चैनल सुपर केबियंस। टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन आंसर ऑफ द स्टोरी ऑफ अमृता ऑफ क्लास फोर्थ EBS। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वेयर इज द विलेज खेजड़ली? दिस इज ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो। You have to locate the village Khejalli. So the answer is, the Khejalli village is in the Jodhpur district of Rajasthan state. So you can find it in the map also. And the next one, who was Amrita? The main character of this story, who was Amrita? Amrita was a brave girl in Khejalli village. Next one, who were the friends of Amrita? The answer is, the trees were the friends of Amrita. I am repeating, the trees were the friends of Amrita. The next one, it is in the page number 32. Is there a place near your house, school, or along the roadside where trees have been planted? So this question is open to everyone. You have to find a place near your house where the trees have been planted. So the answer may be different. Here I am saying about my own house. Yes, there are a number of trees planted in a park near my house. Also, there are many trees planted along my school's boundary wall. So you have to write the answer as per the location of your own house. Next one, why were they planted there? If there are trees, why they have planted trees there? All the trees have been planted there for shade and fresh air, in order to get fresh air, that is oxygen, and shade to take rest. They have planted the trees there. Have you seen anyone taking care of the trees? Who does this? If there are trees, have you seen everyone or anyone else who is taking care of this? And the answer is yes, the gardener takes care of all the trees planted in the gardens and parks. Even in our school also, there is one gardener who takes care of all the plants and trees in the school campus. Have you seen fruits on any of the trees? If yes, who eats these fruits? There are trees around your house. Is there fruits on it? And if there is fruits, who eat all these fruits? Yes, some of the trees bear fruits in particular season, not all time. People who look after these trees eat these fruits. People, suppose the gardener who look after this tree, they eat the fruits of these trees. And also animals like squirrels, monkeys, and some birds also eat these fruits. Next one, this is one description here. Lalita is a girl. Lalita feels that grass and small plants growing near her school wall have not been planted by anyone. Do you know of any place where grass, small plants, or trees are growing on their own without being planted? Yes, it is a very interesting question. There are grass and small plants growing near our schools, but no one has planted it. So the question is that, do you know that any other place where the plants and trees are growing on their own without being planted? So the answer is yes. Forest is a place In forest, forest is a place where grass, small plants or trees grow on their own without being planted. So in forest, there are thousands of trees, plants and grass fields which grows without being planted. The next one, why do you feel they are growing on their own? How do you know that the trees and plants are growing on their own? Plants in forest are growing on their edge. No one has planted them in forest. Seeds get good condition to grow into plants. Means as no one has planted there, so the seeds get the good condition. Automatically the good condition makes the seeds into plants. Water, air and the soil makes the seeds into plants, which is sufficiently available in the forest. The next one, page 34. Do you remember what the elders of this village used to say? Try to remember the first stanza. The villager used to say one sentence. It was in Hindi and the answer is yes, the elders of the village used to say agar ped hai to hum hai. Agar ped hai to hum hai means if trees are there, then also we are there. The next one, do you think we could survive if there were no trees or no animals? Very nice question. Suppose there are not a single tree and not a single animal, then is it possible us to survive? No, we could not survive if there were no trees and no animals, because trees provide us oxygen for breathing. They also give us fruits, vegetables and other useful things. And at the same time, animals are also important as they provide meat, eggs, milk, etc. So it is very much important that trees and animals, without them we can't survive. The next one, write about any one tree. It is of your own choice. You have to write 5 sentences about your own trees. Here I have taken mango tree and there are 5 questions. Let's start. Does the tree flower? Here mango tree. Does the mango tree flower? And the answer is yes, the mango tree has flowers. Do the flowers remain on the tree throughout the year? If there are flowers on the tree, whether it remains in the tree throughout the year? The answer is no, the flowers do not remain on the tree throughout the year. It remains sometimes in some seasons only. In which month do their leaves fall? Leaves fall is a very common feature of all the trees. So generally in the month of October and November, the leaves of the mango trees falls. Do fruits grow on the tree? Yes, fruits grow on the mango tree, which is mango fruits, the king of all the fruits. In which month do they grow? Generally mangoes grow in the month of March, April and May. It may be different in some other states and it may be different for some other type of fruit plants. Have you eaten these fruits? Of course, yes, I have eaten mangoes. So you can write up your own favorite tree. All the 6 questions to be answered accordingly. The next one, page number 36. Why do people hunt? Hunting means killing of animals. So why do people hunt? People hunt animals to get their meat, skin and bones. To get the meat, skin and bones, people generally hunt, and sometimes they hunt for the joy also. There are rules against hunting of some animals. People can be punished for hunting. Why do you think there is this punishment? As it is punishable to hunt, why do you think that punishment should be given for hunting? Punishment is there to prevent hunting and protect animals. If there will be no punishment for hunting, everyone will go hunting, and after few days there will be no animals in the forest. That's why punishment is there to prevent hunting and protect animals. Discuss with your grandparents and write. You can discuss with your grandparents, grandmother, or any senior members in your family. Which birds did they see around them when they were of your age? When they were 10 years old, they might have seen some birds. So the answer is yes, they saw crow, sparrow, parrot, all these birds they have seen at the age of 10. Have the number of some these birds become less? Whether these birds, numbers of these birds have become less? And the answer is yes, the number of birds has become very less. Are there some birds or animals which they cannot see anymore? Do you think that some birds and animals which used to be seen earlier, but nowadays they are not being able to see? Yes, sparrow. Earlier sparrow used to come to our house, but nowadays sparrow is no more able to see, and cheetah is also used to be seen around villages, but nowadays sparrow and cheetah cannot be seen anymore. The next one, page number 37. Shanti's grandfather told her what when he was small child he saw more birds like sparrows and myna than he sees today. Can you make two guesses why their numbers have become less? Shanti's grandfather is saying that at his own period there were thousands of sparrows and myna around them, but nowadays the number has become less. Why? Hunting. The main reason is hunting. People have hunted the birds. And the second one is deforestation. Deforestation means burning of forest and make this into farmhouse, building, all this, or some making factory. So this is called deforestation and the decreasing of forest. So the hunting and the decreasing of forest, deforestation, are main reasons for decreasing population of birds like sparrow and myna. Next one, the khejur tree was the most common tree that grew in Amrita's village. So like as the khejur tree was famous in the Khejali village, the same is which kind of trees can you see a lot of in your own area? Name two such trees and write about them. So you have to find out that which trees are generally found in your own areas. So you have to mention any two trees. I am mentioning one is about the neem tree, and it is a tall evergreen shady tree. Most important, it has medicinal property which help to cure many diseases. So I am writing about neem tree, and another is about mango tree. It is a big tree with dark green leaves. It bears mango fruit which is very tasty. Mango is also named as the king of fruits. So you can write your own two trees which are near your house or near your locality. So this is all for today. You can visit my blog superkbns.blogspot.com for more details about all the e-contents. So Thanks for watching, and in case you have any queries, you can write to akm.kbs@gmail.com. So, but till that, stay home, stay safe. Thank you and have a nice day.